Talking with track owner here at I-80, Joe Kosiski, as we get ready for the Silver Dollar Nationals. And last night you had almost a repeat of last year. I think you have someone that might start buying some part land in Jonathan Davenport out here as he comes up with another $12,000 win like he did last year at the Malvern 50 last night.
Yep. Jonathan won the Malvern Bank Go 50 and last year, popped up with it this year, but he has a pretty convincing win last night, a little more convincing than last year. I think he passed Blomqvist last year, won by .015 or something. I mean, it was one of the closest races in history last year. And
talk about trying to get two of the biggest racing series at one time in one place, logistics, trying to get everything set out. I mean, when you take a look at everything, just as I'm coming up, it's not a 2 or 3 month deal. Is this one of those deals that as soon as it's over with Sunday morning, you're already starting to work it out?
Well, it's pretty close to that. I'm not going to tell you Sunday morning, but in about a week, we start on Monday morning with our meetings of what we done wrong, what we need to do to be better, and things like that. And, you know, start asking the employees, what'd you come up with? So we got it fresh on their mind. So yes, really, we do start right after Sunday, but you just go on and keep trying to work on it. I mean, like you said, it's a nightmare to try to put all this together.
You are one of the few places in Nebraska, in the central area, that was affected by the flooding. You have 63 highways south of here that shut down, and that got delayed. That's going to be a little bit before that gets fixed up. I come across driving up here, and as soon as I hit the state line, you can really see the effects. You've got silo bins collapsed. You've got debris up along the fence line. You can see where they've repaired the railroad tracks and everything. In this area, how much of a hit has that put on you guys?
For the area, at the beginning of the year, it put traffic flow was bad trying to get here. You know, we could see a little bit of an effect, but after a while, the people wanted to fill their urge so bad. There was tracks that were closed up, so they were filling their urge, and we had racers, and I feel sorry for all the people that, you know, suffered from the floods, but we can't stop. There's a lot of disasters that happen, and we all have to go through it, and sometimes we have to keep up with everything just as it's going.
Sometimes a racing night can be a pretty good therapy just to let you escape from everything for a day and just enjoy something for a little bit.
Well, you know, I agree with that. Even though it's a lot of work on the promoter side, it's a lot of work on the race car driver's side, it's a lot of work on the team owner's side. But when you leave the racetrack, or when you leave for the racetrack, it's almost like you're in a different world driving there. You know, it's just something different about it that makes you feel good. I'm ready to be excited, and the adrenaline gets going, and you just go right through it.
Talking about the floods, and Lakeside announced that they may have their first race, they're scheduling for August. You've got to be thinking, when you think about them dealing with two floods, and you're sitting here, and you know, the area's been dealing with it, you've got to feel like you dodged a big bullet.
Well, I'm up on high enough land. I dodged a big bullet because I didn't have that problem. Just right down the interstate here, right, you know, 6 miles down the road, all the cabins and all the stuff that are right there on the Platte River were all flooded. I mean, it was all underwater. So we dodged a bullet because of where we're located, but we still had an effect for people. And I mean, I've got family members that lost their houses that they live in the floods. I talked to Pete quite a bit over at Lakeside, and Pete has a real optimistic outlook that he's going to be ready. He told me August 3rd to August 10th range. He said August 3rd is when he wants to put it out. We were supposed to have two of our Malvern Bank races down there this year. They both got flooded out, you know. Yeah. But let's hope that it just works out the best for Pete, because I know what he's going through. You know, just we had a wind burst here and took down a bunch of our stuff. Not as bad as Wheatland about 8 years ago. And you just can't imagine. It's one thing you fix, and then you fix something else, then you fix, and you just keep thinking, and all of a sudden it's about 3/4 way prepared, and you're back to racing, and you're still trying to catch up from it.
And you bring up Wheatland. That's another place that got a lot of damage from a storm not too long ago, and they made a quick turnaround. They got themselves back up, just ready for the 100.
Yes, I mean, that was what? It was Memorial, right before Memorial Day weekend, because they had the storm for the Show Me and got it all ready for July 13th, so about a 6-week turnaround, and they had a lot of work to do. You know, I'm proud of old Dan Robinson and all that they do down there at Wheatland Speedway.
Talking with Joe Kosiski, owner of I-80 Speedway, as we get ready for the Silver Dollar Nationals. Your prediction, I'm not going to ask you for a trifecta or box anybody. I'm just going to ask you, do you go for the field or do you take JD?
Oh, man. I'm going to take the field. Because taking one car, there's a lot of things that could happen. Yeah. You know what I mean? And that's the only reason I'd take the field, because a lot of things can happen to him. He's on a high cloud, and I heard from an old racer a long time ago, you know, take and savor the moment. So when you're on these moments that you're having, savor them, because it's going to turn around and there's going to be somebody else and they're going to be on top for a while. But if you watched that race last night, Devin Moran come from way deep in the field, out of, if I recall right, out of the B feature, and he was up racing for the lead on the last yellow at 15 to go. Got a little messed up on the restart, but still finished third in the race. That's a hell of a race.
I think a lot of people may say, I just accomplished something, making you speechless for a second, so I take that as a great achievement.
Making me speechless a lot of times is hard, so yeah, I understand where you're coming from.
Well, thanks a lot for joining us real quick. I know you got a busy time coming up ahead as we start Silver Dollar Nationals, but as I said, last year was my first time here. I was in awe. Second time back, I'm still in awe, and I plan on enjoying myself some more.
Well, I hope that you come back next year, too. I mean, we want to, everything we do here, we want to try to just make it bigger each year.
Well, thanks for joining us tonight.
Thank you.